1, 2, 3, 4. The 2012 MCLA tournament here in Greenville, South Carolina continues. You are here with the University of Buffalo Bulls, the 5 seed, and the Arizona State Sun Devils. My name is Michael Brandon. I'm here with Dave Franklin. Dave, we watched this Bulls team play last night. Do you think they have what it takes to get by the Sun Devils?
It's tough to say. Once again, two very different teams with two very different playing styles. Arizona State is trying to get to their third consecutive MCLA National Championship game. They have yet to take the championship trophy home. Buffalo, of course, coming off their first round tournament win, looked incredibly impressive yesterday against a very talented Cal team, also from the West Coast, similar to Arizona State that plays in the SLC. We're surely in for a great one. Buffalo is really going to have to buckle down defensively and take advantage of every opportunity on offense in order to pull out a victory, Mike.
Well, Buffalo just creates a turnover. Arizona State cannot get a shot off on Cage, and Buffalo look to clear.
Mike, the interesting thing to me in this one is the goaltending matchup. Dylan Westfall in there for Arizona State, arguably the best player in the MCLA overall, possibly the MVP of the league. And of course, across the way is number 20, Ryan Lichtman, who had a fantastic performance yesterday.
And there's Westfall on the ground ball. Buffalo couldn't clear, and the Sun Devils will try to come get back on offense here. Zach Mendoza throws back to Westfall. Westfall with the easy clear to Zach Scarano. Scarano up top to Logan Quinn. Logan Quinn gets tripped and a flag comes down. So the Sun Devils will get their first man-up opportunity.
Great play by Logan Quinn to flip the ball to Scarano, keeping it in play. Arizona State now has a free possession as they will head into the man-up, looking for a goal early.
Toronto will invert and dodge. And as he tries to swing it over to Payson Clark, the Sun Devils throw it out and they will have their first man up here in the first quarter action of the quarterfinal round of the 2012 MCLA tournament.
The key player in this game is really Dylan Westfall, once again a potential MVP candidate for the league. Head coach Chris Malone says of his senior goalie, who is for the first time playing without either of his brothers, that he plays his best when the lights are on and when everything is on the line. It certainly is today.
And as Arizona State tries to work the ball around the outside, it is dropped and will have a loose ball push against the Sun Devils, so the Bulls have a big ground ball there and a big turnover for Arizona State on their man down. Penalties released. Hultgren releases from the penalty box. Here is Greg Gebler, who was a goal scorer for the Bulls yesterday. Has another opportunity here, gets in front. Shot, and it's wide. Backed up by the Bulls. So Gebler creates transition again. And maybe, they probably game plan to make sure the ball comes out of his stick and not to let him get to the goal. But that time they didn't read the game plan.
Mike, yesterday Gebler had two great scoring opportunities, one of which he capitalized on the second time around. He went high on the Cal goalkeeper. This time we actually saw him drop his stick and try to go low on Westfall. An interesting approach considering Westfall is a taller frame goaltender. Perhaps going low on him and dropping your stick is the best way to go, but unfortunately the shot sails wide.
Sudek throws up to Fisher, across to Hultgren. Hultgren will dodge from up top against the pole. Runs through the first guy and the second, feeds the crease. Sudek can't handle the ground ball. And Arizona State has another turnover in the books. Nick Hillier has it in the middle of the field. Buffalo has good transition defense. Here's a shot and a goal. Joseph Cosgrove with our first goal of the game. Arizona State takes a 1-0 lead. Bit of a surprise dodge there, and they sneaked one past Lickman, the goalie for the University of Buffalo.
Important for Arizona State to get on the board early. However, Mike, you remember as well as anyone that yesterday Cal got off to an early 3-0 lead against the Bulls, and the Bulls battled back resiliently. So playing from behind early is maybe Buffalo's strong point. We'll have to see.
Arizona State wins another face-off, and Westfall will clear for the Sun Devils. Cooper Pickell clears, gets a pass in front, a shot, and a goal. Dan Davis on the feed from Pickell, and the Sun Devils take their second goal of the game.
Unbelievable play by Cooper Pickell there, wearing the number 15 jersey that, of course, belonged to Ryan Westfall last year. Did a great job of pushing the ball in transition, moving it to his teammate, and getting on the board 2-0.
Zach Handy with another faceoff win. I think that was Buffalo's strong suit yesterday was faceoffs, and so far they haven't looked too great.
Yeah, Kurt Stovdahl was definitely the catalyst for Buffalo yesterday, not only winning faceoffs, being a threat offensively as well. He's been quiet so far in this one.
The Sun Devils sub to the midfield. Martinek throws down to Kyle Dennis. And Dennis will dodge the low wing. Sun Devils and Logan Quinn trying to force his way to the cage. Has a feed up top. Redodge isn't there. Good D from the short stick defender of Buffalo.
Logan Quinn also did a good job of not being pushed into the crease there. He was very, very close to the line, but did a good job of staying on the perimeter. And then, of course, making the good feed up top to Kyle Dennis. Good possession so far for the Sun Devils.
A split dodge and a goal from Ben Martinek, the freshman midfielder, puts the Sun Devils up 3-0 early here in the first quarter.
MB, that was a really, really impressive play by Ben Martinek. He made a great lefty dodge, jumped into his shot, raised his arms to get out of the reach of the defender, and ultimately bounced it through the five hole of Lickman, the Buffalo goaltender.
So here's Handy and Stavball at the faceoff X.
Early 3-0 lead, Mike. You think history is going to repeat itself?
I think Buffalo is a team that unfortunately doesn't start off games very well, but I don't think Arizona State is a team that you can go down early to and still claw yourself back into the ballgame.
Yeah, I agree. Arizona State is really miles away skill level-wise from California Berkeley.
Hillier gets a yellow call. He will retreat, and they sub Logan Quinn in through the midfield. Zach Scarano will dodge from the top, left to right. Buffalo has done a pretty good job stopping the initial dodge. I think a little off-ball defense needs to tighten up. They're letting some backside movement get open for the Sun Devils. Redodge from Scarano. He feeds up top. to Pakel. Pakel gets topside, rolls back to his left, stays in his right hand, and another goal from Arizona State. Their fourth of the day in the first quarter. Pakel re-dodged about three times and put it back behind the Buffalo goalie to take a 4-0 lead.
Cooper Pakel, a freshman on this Arizona State team. It's not only the jersey number, his frame and the way he plays, it's really very much a second coming of Ryan Westfall. He's tall, he's lengthy, he has great stick skills, and he's just doing such a great job filling the voids on the offensive voids on this Arizona State team. Very impressive to see from a freshman, Mike.
Zach Handy with another faceoff win. The Sun Devils have a lot of momentum, and Rockne Rep touches the ball in, and they will regroup, and their second-line midfielders are now in the ballgame.
Rockne Rep has really been the offensive catalyst for Arizona State all season long, really doing a fantastic job of creating for his teammates and more or less stepping it up since Ryan Westfall graduated.
Pakel, the early goal leader, attacks from up top, feeds a crease, checking the ball from Buffalo. Ball's loose. And a big GB by Payson Clark. They get it inside. A falling shot goes wide, and the Bulls will clear.
Ben Martinick looking for his second goal of the game there. Made a really athletic face dodge. Came through, took a shot, falling down. It skipped just wide.
Lichtman throws a long clearing pass to Stadvall. He's checked to the sideline, turns it over, and picks it right back up. Whistle on the far side, loose ball push. And Nate Oberhaus will start for Buffalo. Grogan swings it all the way around to Ron Hatch. Ron Hatch defended by the short stick. Swings it back to Willis. Willis up top to Fisher. A little bit of stagnant offense for Buffalo. The Dodger is doing a good job of creating a little separation, just not a lot of off-ball movement from Buffalo right now. Buffalo gets a great look from Andrew Willis. Westfall is there to make a big save.
I've said it once, I said it again. Westfall is known to play his best when the game is of the utmost importance, when the lights are on, the eyes are on him, and when he needs to get his team a victory in order to advance. That's why he's so fantastic. That's why Arizona State has made it to the last two MCLA National Championship games, falling respectively to Michigan, who is now an NCAA Division I team, and of course, BYU, who is playing at Chapman right behind us.
During the Arizona State clear, they turn the ball over on the sideline. Buffalo clears easily and puts another shot wide of the cage. Grogan will start with the ball behind. The lefty feeds it up to Leifhauser.
Very important for Buffalo to get a good possession here. They really haven't gotten a lot of good looks at the cage. Down early. Their studs have been quiet. This is the time to rise to the occasion for the Bulls.
Let's go,
On the offensive end for Buffalo, number one, Alex Holdgren, number 27, Tommy Sealater, Sudek, and of course, number five, Ryan Grogan, are really the main scoring threats.
Buffalo doesn't seem to be a very big, dodge to pass. They dodge to score a lot. As Holdgren gets his hands free for just a moment, sends one over the net. Bulls can't seem to get anything on Cage right now either. A big shot is deflected and ground balled by the Sun Devils. Westfall has some pressure, almost turns it over. Comes all the way down to the D end for Buffalo.
Westfall usually pretty strong on the clear, does a good job of getting out of the cage, being a help for his defenseman, and usually fires passes right on.
Ball squirts out, picked up by Arizona State, and their bench directs them to slow the ball down. Martinek inverts, and he's getting some pressure from the Buffalo D-Mitty.
Nate Oberhaus was fantastic in Buffalo's opening round game against California. Doesn't really get much on the score sheet, but really does a good job of shutting down his opponent's top offensive opposition and does it with a short stick. Really impressive to see. The short stick D-Mitty, Mike, as you know as well as anybody, is probably one of the most underrated positions, the unsung hero in the sport of lacrosse.
Sure, considering every team tries to take advantage of that. If you have D-Mitties that can strip the ball or force players to their bad spots, it's very valuable. Shot from Arizona State is deflected back to the goalie behind the cage, so Lichtman will walk up the middle of the field.
Lichtman deceptively mobile out of the cage, deceptive speed. Got into a little bit of trouble yesterday against Cal. Drew a few penalties, actually. I think that if Arizona State is able to ride him hard, they might be able to create a mismatch and get some junk goals.
Coming up underneath a minute here in the first quarter, the Sun Devils have a 4-0 lead. Buffalo not getting too many shots on cage. And there's the first goal for the Bulls. Stick side high from Ron Hatch. Still don't see Buffalo being a dodge pass team, but they finally crack past Westfall, and they get on the board right before the end of the first quarter.
Ron Hatch, junior middie, 6'3", 235, just a beast of an athlete, loves to bull dodge, and just does a great job right there of putting his shoulder into the Arizona State defenseman and ripping it past Westfall. If I were Hatch, I'd want to keep the ball. If you score a goal on Dylan Westfall, it's be a monumental point in your lacrosse career. He is very good.
Face-off win from Handy. They have a fast break. And a nice look in front and another goal for Arizona State. Handy starts it off with a great face-off win. And number eight, the sophomore attackman, Justin Straker, puts the fifth goal on the board for the Sun Devils.
Great finish there by Straker. He did a good job of settling into the fast break, cut through across the crease where there was an opening, and finished high. Huge play for Arizona State to completely take down Buffalo's momentum off of the goal from Ron Hatch.
Handy with another big faceoff win. And Coach Malone and the Sun Devils have a timeout. So the Sun Devils have a big early 5-1 lead. And what do you think the Bulls are going to try to change in this timeout to get themselves back in this game?
Well, Mike, from an offensive perspective, I think that they have to be much more aggressive. I think that Ron Hatch is going to have to really take the team on his shoulders. Arizona State is pretty strong defensively, great fundamentally, and Hatch is a bit of an X factor with his size and ability to shoot. Holdgren and Sudek are going to have some tough matchups all day, and I think that Hatch and Stoldvall are going to have to be smooth operators up top in order to make room for their offensive threats, such as Holdgren and, of course, Ryan Grogren, who was a fantastic finisher in the Cal game. When he's point blank in front of the crease, he's pretty much automatic.
Folks, you're watching the 2012 MCLA tournament here on MCLA.us from Greenville, South Carolina. The Division II Final Four is set with St. Thomas and Dayton and GVSU, Grand Valley State, and Davenport, the same Final Four as last year. These are the first of the D1 quarterfinals. Behind us, Chapman has an early hole. They're down 2-0 with BYU. Thankfully, the weather's kind of subsided. It rained a little bit yesterday. It's definitely affected the games today. Still have a squishy field. Hopefully, you know, by the end of this week, when the water dries out, we'll have some great footing.
Yeah, Mike, and let's not forget, toward the end of the later games last night, some small drizzle and a slight storm also pulled through, essentially making the issue worse. But the weather forecast says it's nothing but sunny skies for the rest of the week, so hopefully these fields will dry up. And, of course, the facility for the Final Four has not been being played on over there at Serene Stadium, so when we get there a few days from now, it should be nice, green, and crisp.
So after the timeout, Buffalo putting a little bit more pressure on the Sun Devils, extending out and still playing great short stick D. Just hope their backside defenders don't ball watch too much. Shot goes wide. We end the first quarter. Sun Devils 5, Bulls 1. Buffalo hopefully riding a little bit momentum here, try to get this this game a little bit closer. The Sun Devils done a great job with their intensity on the sideline, pushing transition well, and they're finding guys wide open in front of the cage. Buffalo, on the other hand, is trying to force their dodges a little too much. There's no off-ball movement, and they don't look to feed off their dodges, which is easy to defend. You just slide to them early and put the ball on the ground.
Mike, I couldn't agree more. And the fact of the matter is that Buffalo is going to have to be a lot more diverse when crafting their offensive strategy, because, you know, you're not going to get many garbage goals against Dylan Westfall. No question. I guess it's just a game of chance that the same exact matchup is set up as last year. So if St. Thomas is able to beat Dayton, and if Davenport is able to beat Grand Valley, Pete Moosebrugger's St. Thomas Tommy's squad will have a chance at redemption and a chance to pick up their third MCLA Division II championship over the Davenport Panthers, who won the title last year and will be transitioning to MCLA Division I in the CCLA next year.
Handy with another one-handed ground ball. And the Sun Devils go left to right with another offensive possession. So the deliberate, patient offense for the Sun Devils has them passing the ball around the top of the box. Over to Martinek, and they continue to play catch. Martinek dodges left to right, feeds X, and they have some off-ball movement that Buffalo covers up. Mikkel has a step and a shot right in Lichtman's face. Buffalo gets a ground ball, and they one-man clear it up the middle of the field. Stavdahl gets crushed in the middle of the field. Flag down. Buffalo will get their first man up of the day early here in the second quarter.
Well, an admirable effort by Ben Martinek there, making the diving check to try to dislodge the ball. Ultimately, of course, forcing the Buffalo player to lose his footing. He will draw the penalty, but you got to think that if he got all stick and if the Buffalo player didn't fall to the ground, that would have been one of the cleanest, most impressive checks we've seen all tournament.
So Martinek goes to the penalty box for a one-minute tripping penalty. Holmgren starts with the ball. And Buffalo looks to try to build on their one-goal performance so far.
Brian Powell for Buffalo is a player that's really going to have to move off ball. He started to score late yesterday when he did that. He's been standing still all game, so number 7 in blue is going to have to step it up a notch in order to create more for this Buffalo offense.
Arizona State pressuring out on their man down. Buffalo not getting too many good looks. Grogan steps in, shoot. Top left rip and a goal. Coach, second in the game, Ryan Grogan, the senior attackman.
Buffalo gets their second goal of the game. The score is coming from Hatch and Grogan. Coach Crawford told us yesterday that Grogan's his best attackman, his best finisher, no question. He's automatic when he's alone on the crease and has the ability to dip and dunk on a goaltender. And as you see right there, he's able to score from sharp angles as well. Just a really talented finisher.
Ryan Grogan, senior attackman from upstate New York.
There's Zach Handy again with a faceoff win. He's been key to their success early. Buffalo did a great job against Cal winning faceoffs, and today they're in a hole. Ball's dropped by Arizona State, still alive on the grass. Grogan comes up with the ground ball for a moment. Ball is squirted out and kicked back to Westfall by Ian Anderson. And they fail to advance the ball into the offensive box, which creates a turnover.
Yeah, Rockne Rep was bringing up the ball for Arizona State. He had the afterburners on, unfortunately, just not able to get into the box before time expired. Delay of game on Arizona State. Ball goes back the other way for Buffalo.
Hulkren covered by a pole, gets a step. Feeds up top to Lefthauser, who swings it over to Sudek. Sudek doing a good job protecting his stick. Weathers the slide. And they swing the ball back around. Hulkren has a spin dodge, double comes. Tries to swim, ball comes out. And we have a ground ball fight on the far side of the field.
Ian Anderson has really been doing a good job on the defensive end for Arizona State today. He's been matching up with Holtgren a lot. Holtgren has really been forced to shift and move in any way he possibly can in order to create more separation to get himself in position for an open shot. Number one in blue, Buffalo's leading scorer coming into this tournament, just unable to get it done so far.
So a loose ball push called on the far side. Sun Devils have it. Into their offensive box.
Something that we noticed about Buffalo yesterday is that they really make great personnel decisions. They have a great defensive midi group that's, of course, led by Nate Oberhaus. In a situation like this where you have Alex Holtgren, your main offensive threat on the defensive end, you got to be thinking that Buffalo would like to take advantage of some opportunity to get him off the field and rest his legs.
Wide open step down shot for Logan Quinn, who can't get it on cage. It was deflected at the last moment. Buffalo doing a kind of a spotty job at tightening up on the backside cuts. Zach Scarano with more deliberation at the top of the box. Redodges left to right, goes through two bulls, still has possession of the ball. Great job twirling the stick away from the defenders.
I said earlier that Cooper Pickle seemed to be a second coming of Ryan Westfall. So far, in my opinion, Zach Scarano looks like a second coming of Eric Nelson, who, of course, was Arizona State's leading scorer last year. I believe he still has the career lead for MCLA career points.
Kyle Dennis with a left to right split dodge shot and a goal. The seventh for the Sun Devils. They're building on a lead here in the first half over Buffalo. And we'll see if Handy can control another faceoff and get another possession for the Sun Devils.
Well, it was only a matter of time before Kyle Dennis was going to get on the scoreboard. And Mike, you're a Division I assistant coach. And the thing that's so impressive to me against Arizona State is that more so than any other team that I've ever seen in the MCLA, of course, you know, being coached by a great former Maryland Terp and Chris Malone, is they move the ball fast and crisp, just like most Division I teams, similar style with similar velocity and similar skill.
Yeah, the biggest difference I see is a lot of teams dodge to shoot. whereas a lot of NCAA teams dodge to pass and create a an easy slam dunk shot on the backside.
And would you agree that Arizona State pretty much models themselves more like an NCAA Division I team and doing multiple dodges?
You can tell by how many of their goals are assisted as opposed to unassisted. So the Bulls regroup after the timeout. They start with possession on their bench end. Stavdahl starts, swings it up to Hatch. Hatch will attack the top side and feed back to Willis.
Joe Cosgrove just completely took the right hands away from Hatch right there. Pretty much lined up parallel to him and forced him to his left hand. Good job for a defensive short stick midi. Obviously, Cosgrove is the Arizona State equivalent of Will Oberhaus, two great defensive short stick middies who probably don't get their names mentioned as much as they should.
Grogan takes some slaps as he gets above GLE. The lefty doesn't see what he likes and feeds over to Willis.
Willis was the first one to score for Buffalo yesterday in the Cal game. His goal was a catalyst for Buffalo to continue forward. He's been pretty quiet today.
Grogan has time, shoots right into the stick of Westfall, and Arizona State goes their direction with a fast break. Here comes Joseph Cosgrove, feeds the point man. Great slip underneath from Payson Clark for another Arizona State goal. Froze the defenseman, slipped underneath him, and finished behind the UB goalie.
Surely a fantastic finish and a great goal by Payson Clark there, but the thing that stands out to me is, of course, the transition play of Joseph Cosgrove. You know, there's two sides of being a great defensive midi, Mike. Not only do you have to D up on, you know, one of your opposition's best offensive players and hold him at bay, but in situations like that, when you get a fast break, it's very, very important that you bring your offensive skill set into account, find the open man, and create, as Arizona State just did right there. Great play by Cosgrove, number 10 in white.
Score update behind us, Chapman 2, BYU 2 in the other quarterfinal being played right now. Chapman just tied it up. Another handy face-off win. And Arizona will milk some time off the clock before they get their personnel on. Bakel starts up top. Feeds the GLE. Great slip dodge. Shot and Lickman with a great save. And some activity there on the crease. Crease call against White. The Bulls will clear.
It's really only a matter of time before Arizona State was going to get called for goalie interference or being in the crease, not really allowing Lickman to get a hold of it there. But, you know, Lickman, who was maybe a player of the game for Buffalo yesterday, making a lot of key saves, not having much luck against this very high-octane Arizona State offense today, Mike Brand.
Yeah, much different team here in Arizona State than Cal, and we found that early here in the first half. So after the crease call, Buffalo settles into their offense. Hatch up to number 44, Ryan Sands. Sands over to Lefthauser. Lefthauser works behind. Sees Hatch in the wing. Hatch feeds a crease. Catch Grogan. Goal. The Bulls are back in business with their third goal of the game. Assisted this time from Hatch to Grogan. Found him wide open on the crease, and he buries it behind Westfall. Excuse me, that was Willis on the assist, number 10. So the Bulls have their third of the game. Keeping this interesting. Taking a little momentum away from Arizona State.
Important for Willis to finally step up. As we said, he scored the first goal yesterday in the Cal game. So for him to get an assist right there, make a nice look inside, might start to shift things for Buffalo. But you hear the Arizona State sideline. They're not deterred by anything, and they'll take the ball.
Faceoff violation on Buffalo. Handy wins another. Rep with a head of full steam here on a top dodge left to right. Had Dan Davis open for a moment on the crease, decides to start all over again.
Arizona State's offense likes to isolate up top, and as you said before, Mike, you could hear the Arizona State assistant coaches saying, dodge the pass. But he goes right for it there, straight to goal. Good save by Lichtman.
After the Lichtman save, the Bulls come back into their offensive end. They're waiting on some offensive midfielders to get onto the field. Step in front by Hatch. Willis. Willis can't get the shot off. And they will ride at the midfield line. But Arizona State and Zach Scarano clears easily. Martinek and Dennis play catch up top. A change of personnel, and they'll initiate their offense.
Something interesting to note, Mike, is when you take a look at the rosters of these two teams, Arizona State pretty diverse. They have some Maryland kids, some kids from Georgia, some kids from California, Colorado, Ohio, as well as Arizona. Every kid on Buffalo's roster is from the state of New York outside of Rocky Pagelli, who is a senior attackman who wears number 9. Doesn't see too much playing time, but he's originally from Greensboro, North Carolina.
Looking with another save. Bulls try to clear. Ball's picked up by Fisher right at the midfield line. And he flips to Hultgren.
Hultgren drawing the pole here. Number 5, Taylor Rousseau. No surprise there. Hultgren usually does pretty well when he's matched up with the shorty, but he'll have to figure out how to buy a long pole today.
A turnover by the Bulls as Arizona State pushes transition the other direction. They do have numbers. Let's see if Buffalo can collapse. Good patience by the Sun Devils. Arizona State's doing a really good job of making sure they have the right personnel on the field. Attacking when they can, but being patient. Arizona State dodges across the top, is knocked down, and a loose ball push. Could have been a slash. Arizona State will invert against Hultgren there. After Rep patiently waits at X, the Sun Devils take a timeout here in the second quarter. A lot of action behind us as BYU goes on a 2-goal run, take a 4-3 lead over Chapman.
Mike, I was talking to some of these Arizona State parents before, and what scares them most is BYU. BYU beat Arizona State in the championship game last year. Ted Ferrin, probably the best offensive player in the country. And if there's one thing that the Arizona State fans really don't want, it's another matchup with BYU. They'd like to see the Cougars go down, and they're pretty confident they could handle anybody else left in this tournament field.
So the stall that happened before the timeout carries over, and they're punched in with a stall warning.
Quick teaching moment here, of course, and when you're possessing the offensive end, something you normally see at the end of close games, but if you don't seem to be going to the goal and passing around the offensive end, the ref will call a stall warning, and at that point, as an offensive squad, you have to keep the ball in the air and inside, in the stick, in the air, and inside the interior box of the offensive end.
Bakel sweeps behind the net, gets inside, checked from behind, trail check, a shot, goes wide, ground ball fight behind. And it's picked up by Arizona State. They're instructed once again to keep it in the box. Shot from Arizona State is backed up with almost a minute left in the first half. Arizona State may wait here for the last shot.
And as predicted, using the behind the net area more, Justin Straker holds it now. Opposed to going from up top, he's going to look to create from behind.
Straker makes some shifty moves at X. Gets a step backside. Shot and a goal. A great look from Straker to Logan Quinn. Change of direction on the goal. He had no chance of seeing the ball as it was passed over his head. And ASU scores their eighth goal of the game to go up 8-3 here in the second quarter.
Yeah, Mike, that ball pretty much crossed the goal line and made the back of the net move before Lickman even knew where it was. He was still busy trying to read the pass from behind the cage. Couldn't see it out of the corner of his eye, and right there, Logan Quinn had nothing but net to look at.
Handy continues his dominance of the faceoff X, and Hillier comes away with the ground ball. Hillier gets a step, draws a slide, runs through it, shot. Bounces way up top, and a ground ball by Zach Scarano. Coming up on 10 seconds left in the quarter. Gabler checks the ball out of the stick. And right at the half, the ball is flicked out by Buffalo. And they don't get a shot off, so Arizona State with an 8-3 lead here at the half. Okay, folks, welcome back to second half action of the MCLA tournament. Buffalo and Arizona State. Arizona State has a 8-3 lead. The Arizona State faceoff man Handy lost probably his first of the game. Stovdahl did a great job to get inside, and a goal right off the bat, right off the opening faceoff. Number 26, Kurt Stavdahl, brings the Bulls within four goals here in probably a five-second goal.
Huge momentum shifter for Buffalo to get a goal within the first 5 seconds of the half, especially from Kurt Stovdahl. He was the guy that really turned it on yesterday in the second half for Buffalo and propelled the Bulls into victory. Perhaps Buffalo is a second-half team and might make this one interesting. Now that Stovdahl is winning faceoffs and taking it straight to goal and establishing himself as an offensive threat, opens things up a bit.
Stovdahl with another big faceoff victory for the Bulls. Sudek handles up to Fisher, who passes up to Hatch. Hatch will dodge right to left. Goes through the second slide. Feeds Grogan behind. Sudek working on the close GLE. Has a step, shoots. Big save by Westfall. And the Sun Devils are out.
Ian Connell, the close defenseman for Arizona State, number 50 in white, did a good job of playing some good man defense there on Sudak.
Sun Devils unable to clear as Josiah Norton, the junior defenseman, lets the ball roll out on the sideline. Arizona State chases on the clear. Bulls get over midfield, and they successfully clear.
We now see Will Oberhaus carry the ball, a guy we talk about a lot in the defensive end. We saw Arizona State's D-Mitty, Joe Cosgrove, get involved with an assist earlier. Oberhaus now doing a good job of utilizing his stick skills and bringing it into the offensive end for Buffalo.
Sudak throws back to Grogan. Over to Willis and up top to Hulkrin. Left Fowler hesitates, goes back to Grogan. Willis dodges, there's some cutters, feeds up top to Hulkrin. Hulkrin dodges the pole, gets his hands free for a moment, swims the slide, tries to go through the triple, lose the ball, but Grogan is there to corral the loose ball. Grogan, the lefty, gets ahead of the net, but is turned back by the Arizona State defense. Shot squirts by Westfall, backed up by Willis. And early in the third quarter, it's been all Bulls. Willis on a quick cut, feed to Sands. Cannot connect. Arizona State pushes transition. And now they will gather the troops.
Good start to the second half for Buffalo. Arizona State doing some shifty things on offense as they get their first possession of the half. Once again, going back to their game up top toward the end of the first half, they were dodging more from behind. Now they're going more to the similar style of play that we saw when the game first started. And they're really trying to isolate from up top and utilize the northern section of the scoring area.
So Martinek has Hultgren, an offensive mini trapped on D. And look to exploit that matchup.
Alex Hultgren, really a very solid all-around middie out of Grand Island High School in upstate New York. But again, the thing that Buffalo is so great at is making good personnel decisions. And you got to be thinking, if you're Coach Crawford, you'd really rather have Nate Oberhaus D-ing up opposed to Hultgren.
And Martinek gets past the first defender and rips one in the top left corner to give Arizona State their first goal of the second half and a 9-3 lead, and the Sun Devil bench erupts.
We work around some clock issues here. Alex Hultgren a little bit frustrated again, getting caught on defense there. Martinek gets the goal. You got to think if at some point Nate Oberhaus was able to get into the game, that that could have been prevented. But the referees will now look to rectify the clock issue. Buffalo will try to get back to where they were when this second half first started, a little bit deflated after Arizona State gets on the board there. But as Kurt Stovall comes into the faceoff circle, you know that the Bulls are resilient, Mike.
Another one-handed ground ball for Handy, but it is turned over quickly. Stavdahl with a great trail check gives the Bulls another opportunity. Hatch sprints out of the box. And they feed over to Willis, who loses his footing and turns it over to the Sun Devils.
That pass just a bit too high for Willis. He did the best he could to try to bring it down in his stick, lost his footing, and costly turnover for the Bulls.
Straker and Pickell play catch up top with Logan Quinn. Quinn feeds Payson Clark. Clark attacks the pole. Nothing doing. Smartly feeds out to Logan Quinn. Quinn to Pickell. A dodge and a shoot. Arizona State has another goal. A no slide came from the Bulls, and he buries it behind Lichtman.
Cooper Pickell finishes the hat trick. Again, a very lengthy offensive midfielder wearing the number 15 jersey. So many similarities between him and Ryan Westfall, who just graduated last year. Of course, Dylan's older brother. He has two older brothers. Of course, the oldest, Tyler, graduated two seasons ago. But Arizona State has really come a long way. Just a fantastic program headed up by Chris Malone.
Handy and Stavdahl go at it again. Handy pops it out to himself. Can't get the ground ball. Second try, he picks it up and loses it once again. Stavdahl, another hustle play, another trail check. And he almost loses it himself. Stavdahl up to Overhouse. Grogan handles down to Willis. Willis over to Sudek. Sudek up top to Hatch. Joey Fisher dodges right to left. Splits back to his middle. As the Arizona State defender falls, they force feed Grogan inside, and it squirts back to Willis.
We now see Joe Fisher start to get involved in the offensive end. We hadn't said his name much today. And now Hatch, of course, will draw a long pull, making it difficult for him to penetrate with that big frame of his.
Tough feed inside for Stavdahl, but he gets the shot off the chest of Westfall. Big clearing pass squirts through to the Buffalo defenseman. And as he crosses midfield, he throws it right back to Kinesi. Excuse me, that was Hillier. Straker controls in the bottom corner, and the Sun Devils will get their personnel back on the field, regroup, and attack the cage. Kyle Dennis harassed by Oberhaus up top. Feeds back up to Logan Quinn. Logan Quinn, quick pass to the backside. Cannot see Cage. Squirts to the back corner, and the Devils retain possession.
Good look at...
Clark gets a step on his man. Double comes. He runs through that as well. Rolls back, shoots, and scores. Payson Clark, on a great change of direction, made two defensemen fall down. And Arizona State takes a big 8-goal lead.
Really impressive play there by Payson Clark. He had taken a shot previous to the one he scored on. Just didn't get quite a good look at the net. Almost shot it from below GLE. But his teammates did a good job to recover, get the ball back to him. Unbelievable isolation move to ultimately put two Buffalo defenders on the ground, and a great spinning diving finish past Lichtman.
Handy has another faceoff win as Pickell gets the ground ball. So past the midway point in the third quarter, the Sun Devils have a 10-4 lead over the Buffalo Bulls. Coach Malone calls out Devil, and Bartonek takes it to the midfield line. Oberhaus giving some big slashes and checks, but to no success. Bartonek will take the ball way up top to the top of the box, and they will reinitiate.
Arizona State really didn't fare so well when they changed their offensive scheme in order to try to work from behind toward the end of the first half. They're going back to going up top now, and it's really benefited them so far.
Good slide, and the feed wasn't there. It leaks back to Lichtman, and the Bulls will try to clear. Holcren returns to the field, and the Bulls will repossess the ball.
Very important for Holtgren not to get too frustrated here. He is the straw that stirs the drink for Buffalo. He needs to be resilient and continue to try to dodge and create and get on the score sheet. He's too good of a player not to.
Big lob pass from Holtgren. Tries to get Sudek a look, nothing there, and he swings it back to Brian Powell. Powell to Grogan. Grogan up top to Sands. Sands initiates his dodge right to right. Tries to feed the GLE. It's over Powell's head. Turned over by the Bulls. Arizona State will clear.
Brian Powell, only 5'7", the smallest attackman in the Buffalo starting lineup. He's been quiet today, but when you throw a pass a few feet over his head, it certainly doesn't help the issue.
Slick clearing pass for the Devils, and they jog it into their offensive end.
For the most part, Arizona State has been very, very good and very consistent on the clear today, Mike.
Kyle Dennis does a good job with the clear and feeds it over to Clark. And it comes all the way around to Scarano. They will dodge Holtgren again with Kyle Dennis. There's a shot from Payson Clark off the head of a Buffalo defender. Scrum at the faceoff X. Ball's loose, and we'll get a loose ball push against Arizona State.
Bit of a scary moment there as Joe Norton took that one right off the head. Sometimes there are tragedies in this sport where if that hits you at the wrong angle, at the wrong speed, it could create some problems, but there have been some really great developments to the equipment and the helmets that these players are wearing. It's really excellent that all these MCLA teams are very diligent to get the best possible equipment. The fact that Nike sponsors a lot of these teams is a great help, and great to see Norton take one off the head and continue to play.
The Bulls try to force a play. Brian Powell loses the ball right to Westfall. Sun Devils look to clear. Easy clearing pass from Westfall up to Ian Anderson. Anderson gets into the box and retreats back to the defensive end. Sun Devils don't have all of their offensive players in the box yet, and they're instructed to take their time.
Mike, what are your responsibilities at Brown University's managing the box? How would you assess what you've seen here in the MCLA tournament in regards to box management?
Well, the big difference is we subbed basically exclusively through the midfield line. We don't really come through the box. It creates transition for us, and if we can create a mismatch or trap an offensive midfielder on the field, that's what we like to do. A lot more defined roles at the varsity level, a little bit more than at the MCLA level. 15 on 15. Cooper Pickell gets past the Buffalo defender but can't get the ball on frame. And they repossess with Justin Straker in the back corner.
Cooper Pickell already has a hat trick in this game. He's hungry. He's looking for more. Again, the young man that wore the number 15 jersey before him had multiple 4 and 5 goal games in his career. He's looking to do the same here today.
Straker makes his defender fall. He throws to Clark, but we have a turnover for Arizona State.
I think perhaps that was a ward-off call that we didn't hear. I think as Arizona State was possessing, the player pushed off with his offhand. We don't see much of that at the college level, even here in the MCLA. But regardless, it is not allowed, and Buffalo regains possession.
So Gebler clears up to Oberhaus, Oberhaus to Hultgren. And he touches it in the offensive box. Under 1 minute here in the third quarter. Arizona State hangs on to a 10-4 lead. The Bulls of Buffalo just won't seem to go away. They're getting a lot of offensive possessions, but they haven't been able to capitalize on many of them. A lot of one-man dodging through the entire team. A shot from Stavdahl goes right into the stick of Ryan Westfall, but Hultgren is there to pick up an errant clear.
Yeah, Zach Mendoza couldn't get the handle there for Arizona State. Dylan Westfall put the pass right in his stick, but not able to crowd, and Buffalo gets the ball back.
Sudek throws back to Sands. Sands has time to catch and shoot, but it's deflected, and Buffalo retains possession.
Dylan Westfall came out of the cage, took the angle away from Sands, didn't have much to look at. Shot hit him pretty squarely in the helmet, and play continues with Buffalo.
Hultgren goes right to left under 10 seconds. Can't get a good shot off. 1 second remaining in the third quarter. And the Bulls fire it in and can't get a shot off. So the end of third, it is Arizona State 10, Buffalo 4. Dave, tell us what you think about this third quarter. And did Arizona State come out with enough firepower to put the nail in the coffin against the Bulls?
I think it remains to be seen. Not so much. I think that Buffalo can still mount a comeback. We've seen them come back before against West Coast teams. They're a very talented squad, but you know they have some separation on the score sheet. It's very, very hard to get one by Dylan Westfall, perhaps the hardest goalie to score on in the country as far as the MCLA is concerned. And it's not looking too good for Buffalo right now, but it's not over yet.
Okay, folks, end of the third quarter. We're going to go to a quick break. You're watching the MCLA 2012 tournament on MCLA.us. Okay, folks, we're back 11-4. Arizona State has a lead over the University of Buffalo in the 2012 quarterfinal of the MCLA tournament on the Division I bracket. Opening faceoff is picked up by the Sun Devils. Zach Haney doing a great job with the faceoffs. Right off the bat, they get a good look at the cage. They will regroup. Westfall throwing a great outlet pass to get the ball into their offensive end. Deflected pass rolls almost offsides, but it is picked up by Arizona State and Scarano. Here's Logan Quinn, feeds it back up to Scarano. And Scarano throws over to Quinn. Every Arizona State possession starts off with about a good 30 seconds being taken off the clock. They really settle the ball down well before they initiate.
Also important to note that they take their time coming in and getting out of the box. Limits the referee's ability to make a stall call on them. And once again, kills more clock.
Shot and a goal. Their 12th goal. They're tripling up on the University of Buffalo right now, 12-4. And the University of Buffalo bench seems a little bit flat to our left.
Well, from an individual dodging standpoint, Zach Scarano has really been the most impressive player for me in this game. And right there, he does a good job of getting himself back on the score sheet. Good job of isolating from behind and putting it over the goalie, over the shoulder of Lickman.
Gebler for Buffalo gets the ground ball. He carries over the midfield line. Has no one to pass to yet, so he will touch it in and roll back and feed it to Powell. Grogan subs through the midfield line at the box and has a feed from Willis. So their best attackman gets a shorty matchup. Slide comes early.
Not typical to see Grogan so far extended in the offensive zone. He's usually a pretty tight crease guy. Arizona State really stretching out this Buffalo offense.
Fisher back to Grogan, feet inside. Stavdahl almost gets pushed in the back, and the Arizona State bench revels in the great defensive effort. Feet inside to Stavdahl, passes it basically right to Restfall as he was falling down.
Great look there by Grogan. You know, Westfall makes a lot of saves that he makes look easy. It seems like it goes stick to stick, and it's definitely a testament to his vision, his ability to stop the ball, but you got to understand that the shots that they're taking on him, it wouldn't be such easy saves on other goaltenders, Mike.
Yeah, Pakel clears. Over to Kyle Dennis. Dennis up to Logan Quinn. It seems like Arizona State has used the same group of midfielders on offense the entire game with this patient style of offense. They can afford to keep the same guys out there. The Arizona State almost turns it over. It's tipped out by Buffalo. And now their entire offensive midfield line is in. And they will attack from X. So here's Quinn, covered by a long pole.
A name we haven't mentioned a lot is Tim Osborne, wearing the number 28 jersey in blue for Buffalo. A very talented defenseman who played a great game yesterday. Now matching up with Logan Quinn of Arizona State.
Quinn feeds the crease. Ball lands on the carpet. Ball squirts out to an Arizona State stick. But the shot is backed up by Buffalo. Eleven minutes remaining here in the fourth quarter as Arizona State has a nice eight-goal lead over Buffalo. The Bulls seem to be de-energized here in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, once again, a testament to Arizona State's defensive style of play. They've done a good job getting all over these Buffalo attackmen, not giving them much to look at, and their clear has been outstanding. Again, you see Dylan Westfall getting out of his cage, giving his defenseman some support, and he can carry. Dylan Westfall actually scored a goal this season, Mike. He actually went east to west and went all the way in on a Michigan State goaltender. We'll be seeing them next against Cal Poly. Dylan Westfall scored a goal this season as a goaltender against Michigan State.
So Scarano will invert. Looks like they're sending out a double team early. And we have a whistle and a timeout call at the 10-minute mark of the fourth quarter. Arizona State 12, Buffalo 4.
Mike, something interesting to point out for all the gearheads there is that for the most part, Arizona State kind of ditched their Sun Devil logo. You don't see it very much in their football uniform. They're more about the trident these days. The Arizona State lacrosse team does incorporate the trident into the uniform. However, they still rock the old school Sun Devil right there on their helmet. Some people say that Arizona State has some of the best looking uniforms in the league.
Off the restart, Andy Adams starts with the ball. Covered by Buffalo's number 14, a 14-on-14 matchup. And looks like he's going to run out some time on the back line here.
Yep, A.J. Schnaffner, number 14 in white for Arizona State, going against Andy Adam, number 14 in blue for Buffalo. It's funny, we actually joked around and said we'll just call him Double A. I actually hear the Buffalo players actually calling that, but apparently that was a nickname that somebody else came up with before us, Mike.
Rockney Rep dodging behind. I think Arizona State's putting a little bit of patient offense. I know they have been doing that all game, but I think now more than ever they're looking to get perfect shots. Lichtman comes out of the cage, but Malone screams out yellow, and they will retreat to the X, and they have to keep it into the box. So they're punched in now. And Buffalo look to get a turnover here.
Rockne Rep has been carrying the ball now for Arizona State for a very long time. He actually wanted a slash call earlier as he caught a brush from a Buffalo defenseman. But now he moves it over, and Arizona State once again, of course, as predicted, called for the stall with their very patient offense and need to keep it in the box.
Spender with the ball, double comes, two defensemen. They do create a turnover, but it slips by the defenseman of Buffalo. If it comes out of the box here, it will be a whistle. It's close to the line to come out of the box, but the Arizona State Sun Devils kept it in, and they have another possession with Justin Straker. As the Bulls dislodge the ball, it rolls off the back line, and they're unable to clear. Ball goes back to Arizona State. Straker's guarded by Gebler. These Buffalo defensemen must be awful tired, considering how much D they've had to play. Gebler gets it out, Lickman out to get a ground ball. He is successful. And he throws a big, long pass over to the Buffalo D mid in the far side. So the Bulls have another opportunity here on offense to get a little bit closer. The time's running out on the 2012 Bulls. Last year was their first year in the Nationals, in the MCLA. They did qualify for the USILA years back, this year being their first year of ever winning a tournament game. So a lot of achievements here for the Bulls. I know this is not the way they wanted to end, but the program is in a better place than it was last season.
Yeah, no question. They made it to the tournament last season. They won the Pioneer League and got it here, but they did not win their first round game. They picked up their first ever first round tournament win against Cal yesterday as Westfall picks up a big save. But yeah, this Buffalo program has gone through quite a bit of transition. Back in the USLIA days, they competed in the CCLA and would typically follow both Michigan and Oakland here to the national tournament. They had some down years, transitioned into the Pioneer League, and have established themselves as a power once again.
Stabdahl takes a shot, Westfall with another save. And Sudek comes away with it. Double comes on Sudek's back, he sees it, feeds up top to Hulgren. Hulgren gets inside and scores. Alex Hulgren sticks side high over the Arizona State goalie and the Buffalo bench. Doesn't really give him too much celebration on that one.
And it's really unfortunate because you could see here Holtgren's actually a little bit hurt. He caught a slash there. I don't know if he caught just a stinger in the arm. Maybe might have some shoulder issues here. But great job of him to isolate there, get in deep, and put it by Westfall. But, man, he really seems to be hurting. Mike, this is, like you, a fellow alumni of Grand Island High School in upstate New York, a fantastic player, a senior middie who wears the number one jersey, a talented player. I hope he's okay, but so glad to see him score a goal in his final game. He's really holding that arm. I hope he didn't break something.
Yeah, it's great to watch Alex. You know, I've seen him play lacrosse over the years since he was a little kid. Happy to see him get a goal. Let's hope that injury isn't too bad. As the defender of University of Buffalo tries to take the ball away, they get a slash to the face mask. Penalty coming up.
Yeah,
still alive in the box.
A little bit of over-aggression there by Chris Sedorakis. Buffalo defenseman wears number 23 in blue. He'll get the slash penalty.
So the ball's knocked out of the box. Man up for Arizona State. I wouldn't be surprised if they don't take a shot and they take advantage of this this odd number situation and milk the 1 minute off the clock.
Yeah, really good opportunity here for Arizona State to spread out their offense, move the ball around, come in and out of the box, take advantage of the man-up opportunity. No reason to score more goals, just take time off the clock and close this one out. And, you know, it's important to keep your players healthy. Maybe Arizona State might get deeper into their bench pretty soon. You don't really want your top guys going straight to goal because the last thing you need is an injury before the final four, Mike.
Yeah, and just as I predicted, the Sun Devils man-up consists of an open set, a spread-out set, and they will wait for the clock to tick past.
Yeah, interesting look here. A bit of a 3-1-2, two guys behind. You see Justin Schrager there on the crease, and up top you have of course Zach Scarano, as well as Martinick and Dan Davis, just moving the ball around in the air on their feet. And look at this, Dylan Westfall, of course, the senior goalie, looking to evade injury, comes out of the game, and coming in relief is Brandon Propp. Brandon Propp, a freshman goalie out of California. He will relieve Westfall here, and interesting for Arizona State to actually make that move on a fly.
So the penalty is released. They're punched into a stall warning. And Gebler tries to poke the ball away. And does a good job of that on a backhanded Rusty Gatecheck. Pops the ball out of the back line, and Buffalo will clear.
Mike, let me ask you, would Lars Tiffany ever change out a goalie in a live scenario like that? It was pretty safe. It was man up. They were possessing the ball. Obviously, you want to make that switch, but do you change a goalie during a live possession like that? Is it safe?
Yeah, certainly. I think the fact that they have to play, 3 to 4 games this week influences that decision. And with the fact that they've been able to possess the ball basically whenever they want to, gives them an open license to sub on the fly. So Grogan has been subbing through the penalty box to get the shorty matchup. He gets that, tries to feed the middle to Hatch, and Buffalo has another turnover. The new goalie Propp has his first outlet pass of the game, and as Arizona State clears easily.
And as Dylan Westfall will graduate out of this Arizona State program at season's end, you got to think that Brandon Propp might be the new guy in net for Arizona State moving forward in seasons to come.
That's definitely a big hole to fill, and the fact that he's going to get some time tonight and he got some yesterday is very valuable to him.
A big hole to fill and big shoes to fill as well, not only literally but figuratively. Brandon Propp, a freshman goalie, 185 pounds. Dylan Westfall, a solid 215. Two different goalies, two different styles, but certainly a pivotal transitional move for Arizona State and going into the 2013 season, as the Westfall brothers will have completely ended their playing careers with Arizona State. But Coach Malone loves them. He stays in close contact with them. Ryan and Tyler now work in medical sales on the West Coast, and stays in close touch with his brother and their brother and their former coach. Hopefully they're watching right now on MCLA.us as Arizona State looks to get back into the Final Four and hopefully a third consecutive national championship game, looking for their first national championship, having lost those outings with Michigan and BYU.
So we came up on 2 minutes remaining here in the fourth quarter. Arizona State moving the ball around. Buffalo has brought their goalie out to play D, trying to create any sort of turnover.
Ryan Lickman, only a junior goalie, so he'll be back. He'll be certainly a key returner for Buffalo. He played great yesterday, not his best game today, but it's hard. It's hard to look good on the score sheet when you're going up against the high-octane offense such as Arizona State. Now we're really starting to see ASU go deeper into their bench, get some fresh legs on the field, and preserve the energy and health of their starters.
Sudek feeds the inside to Powell. It's checked right away. And we have a hold call. Goes back to Buffalo. And under 2 minutes here in the fourth quarter, Coach Malone calls his second timeout, and Arizona State will put the proper personnel back on the field.
Mike, we see here Dylan Westfall doing a great job, being a great teammate, continuing to support his teammates, getting there, saying what up to the guy that replaced him in the net, telling his guys to get back on the bench, keeping everybody composed. just a true leader. You know, he's done a good job of following suit with his two older brothers. They're out there in Tempe, Arizona. Again, big shoes to fill. He wears number 22 this year. He usually wears 20 in seasons past. Arizona State actually had some sizing issues when they ordered their jersey, so number 20 did not fit Dylan, so he decided to wear the number 22, which was, of course, the number that Tyler wore at Arizona State. Nice tribute to his oldest brother.
So 1:10 left in this quarterfinal game. Arizona State has a 12-5 lead over Buffalo. They've basically possessed the ball this entire quarter and worked most of the clock off by just moving the ball, staying in the box, and not not getting stripped too often. Buffalo's had a couple strips here late, but could have used that back in the third quarter.
Yeah, now you see Nate Oberhaas retake the field for Buffalo. Actually on an offensive set, so you got to be thinking that Coach Crawford maybe wants to reward his defensive midi, his junior defensive midi, with an offensive set here. And as this young man in the number 12 jersey for Blue, not being involved in the offensive set, a bit of a trickery move as he comes in and releases Ryan Grogan, who is back on D.
So now, Grogan subs to the midfield line to get the short stick matchup. I'm not sure that that's going to create too much, as you know Arizona State will just slide to him every time. Grogan ground ball to the backside, catching a shot for Willis. Too little too late for the Bulls.
Great two-man play there, Mike. Grogan did a good job of working the perimeter, kept his head up, fired a nice feed into Willis, who made a nice cut, and finished low.
Under a minute here in the fourth quarter, looks like Arizona State will be playing in the semifinals in Serene Stadium. And to add insult to injury, Sam Lockett, a junior midfielder, wins a faceoff for Arizona State. And the time runs out on the Buffalo Bulls. Under 2 minutes, they have to keep it in the box. And the Bulls defensemen are caught on the run.
ASU has been called for stall warnings a few times late in this game, so here in the last 2 minutes, they're no stranger to this sort of situation, as again, some more fresh legs. Andrew Truesdale now seeing some time for Arizona State, number 9 in the white jersey. Gets the ball knocked down there.
And there you have it, folks, the final here from Greenville. Arizona State 12, Buffalo 5. Arizona State will move on to the semis. The CCLA Buffalo Bulls will have to regroup for 2013. So the PCLL champion Bulls go down to the SLC, Arizona State Sun Devils. We will have the matchup after all the Division I games are over. But for now, Dave, just recap the game and what you thought made this win so easy for Arizona State.
ASU did a good job of, most importantly, scoring early and often, got off to a great start, didn't allow Buffalo back into the game. You know that Buffalo's a resilient team that has shown their prowess in games past, such as Cal, but Arizona State really got off to an early lead here, never looked back, and got production out of all of their top players, and even got to go deep into their bench later in the game to preserve some legs and get some experience for some of their younger players.
So for Dave Franklin, my name is Michael Brand. We'll be back with the Michigan State-Cal Poly game just in a few. But we want to thank you for watching on MCLA.us. We hope you stick around to watch the rest of the games and the rest of the tournament, and we'll see you later.